Step one, wake up early, gonna rise with the sun. Step two, get some good, some food in you. Step three, think real hard about what you wanna be. Step four, fuck everybody, just do your thing.
Wake up, today's gonna be a good day. 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 Set your affirmations, aspirations. I got shit to do, the aftermath of preparation. Good food, good mood, blood in circulation. One step at a time, yeah, that's how you make it. Set a goal you control and the steps you take them. I try to pick one thought, have some concentration. And if I make a mistake, it's called education. I try to do this every day, call it replication. Wake up, today's gonna be a good day. Wake up.
The gift of marriage brings husband and wife together in the delight and tenderness of sexual union and joyful commitment to the end of their lives. It is given as the foundation of family life in which children are born and nurtured, and in which each member of the family, in good times and in bad, may find strength, companionship and comfort, and grow to maturity in love. Marriage is a way of life made holy by God and blessed by the presence of our Lord Jesus Christ with those celebrating the wedding at Cana in Galilee. Marriage is a sign of unity and loyalty which all should uphold and honour. It enriches society and strengthens community. No one should enter into it lightly or selfishly, but reverently and responsibly in the sight of Almighty God. Victoria and Richard, you are to enter into this way of life. They will each give their consent to the other and make solemn vows. And in token of this, they will each give and receive a ring. We pray for you both that the Holy Spirit will guide and strengthen you, that you may fulfill God's purposes for the whole of your earthly life together. Amen. So, Dad, get ready. Who gives this bride away? Wonderful. Please hand her to her groom. Thank you, best man. Dad, please be seated. And the wedding couple, do please come onto the charts and sit. So, first, I am required to ask anyone present who knows the reason why these persons may not lawfully marry to declare it now. That's just a cough. Wonderful. We can take that off. Let's move on. So, to you this morning, this afternoon, Richard and Victoria, the vows you are about to take are to be made in the presence of God. who is judge of all and knows all the secrets of our hearts. Therefore, if either of you know a reason why you may not lawfully marry, you must declare it now. Good. So, to the bridegroom, your answer is, I will. Nice and loud. Richard White, will you take Victoria Ann Farndon to be your wife? I'll tell you what, these are really important. Would you mind standing for me?
Sure.
Thank you. Richard White, will you take Victoria Ann Farndon to be your wife? Will you love her, comfort her, honour and protect her, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Wonderful. Right answer. Same response for you. Victoria Ann Farndon, will you take Richard White to be your husband? Will you love him, comfort him, honour and protect him, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live? Wonderful. We're going to hear their response first. Congregation, the answer is we will. So, the question to you. Will you, the families and friends of Victoria and Richard, support and uphold them in their marriage now and in the years to come?
We will.
Wonderful. Yes. We're halfway there. Take a seat. Wonderful. Is Victoria's mum, Angie, here? Are you reading Union?
Yep.
Would you like to come forward then and read that? Thank you so much. You have the text. Wonderful. You rest on that stuff.
You've known each other from the first glance of acquaintance, this point of commitment. At some point, you decided to marry. And from that moment of yes to this moment of yes, indeed, you've been making commitments in an informal way. All those conversations that were held in a car over a meal, during long walks, all those conversations that began with, when we married and continued with, I will, you will, we will, all those late night talks that included someday, somehow, and maybe, and all those promises that were unspoken matters of the heart. All these common things and more are the real process of a wedding. The symbolic vows that you're about to make are a way of saying to one another, you know all those things that we've promised and hoped and dreamed? Well, I meant it all, every word. Look at one another and remember this moment in time. Before this moment, we've been many things to one another. Acquaintance, friend, companion, lover, dancing partner, and even teacher for you who knows much from one another these past few years. And shortly you'll say a few words that will take you across the threshold of life and things between you will never be quite the same. But after today, you'll say to the world, this is my husband, this is my wife.
I'm so proud of you guys for getting this far. I love you guys so much and can't wait to see your future together. I'm happy today is the day that you have got married. You both are perfect for each other. Lots of
fun. After the years of being engaged, the day is finally here. You are both the best people in my life, my ultimate best friend. I couldn't begin to thank you for everything you have done. And I love you both so much.
Bless you both for those heartfelt but unexpected messages from the heart. Thank you so much to all of you. So we come to the vows. So I think I'd like you to both stand.
Yeah.
And if we could have the chairs taken to one side, that would be wonderful. Please do not marry me. Marry each other. Wonderful. That's it. So, the bride, will you take your bride's hand, please? Wonderful. Thank you. So, repeat these words, Richard, after me.
Yeah.
I, Richard White,
I, Richard Light.
Take you, Victoria Ann Farndon.
Take you, Victoria Ann Farndon.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
According to God's holy law.
According to God's holy law.
In the presence of God, I make this vow.
In the presence of God, I make this vow.
Wonderful. Loose hands. Would you offer your hand to your husband? Thank you. On top. Wonderful. Thank you. So please, Victoria, repeat after me. I, Victoria Ann Farndon. Nice and slow. Nice and slow. I'll say it again. I, Victoria Ann Farndon. There's no rush. There's no rush. Breathe. Take you, Richard White.
Take you, Richard
White. To be my husband.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
Richer,
in sickness and in health.
In sickness and
in health. To love and to cherish. Till death do us part. According to God's holy law.
According to God's holy law.
In the presence of God, I make this vow.
In the presence of God, I make this vow.
Wonderful, thank you. Please. Can the ring bearer step forward, please? Is there a ring bearer? Wonderful. May I have the ring, please?
Thank you so much.
Isn't that wonderful? So, we are going to pray a blessing of God over the ring. So please join me in prayer. Heavenly Father, by your blessing, let these rings be to Richard and Victoria a symbol of your unending love and faithfulness, to remind them of the vow and covenant which they have made this day, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. So, Richard, you go first. This is giving you the ring. And so with your left hand, hold your wife's ring for me. Wonderful. So you're going to hold it on there, repeat these words after me. So to Victoria. Victoria, I give you this ring.
Victoria, I give you this ring.
As a sign of our marriage.
As a sign of our marriage.
With my body, I honour you.
With my body, I honour you.
All that I am, I give to you.
All that I am, I give to you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
Within the love of God.
Within the love of God.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
So Victoria, please repeat after me. Richard, I give you this ring.
Richard, I give you this ring.
As a sign of our marriage.
As a sign of our marriage.
With my body, I honour you.
My body, I honour you.
All that I am, I give to you.
All that I am, I give to you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
Within the love of God.
Within the love of God.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Father, Son.
Wonderful. So let's keep hands held together. We're going to proclaim now. We're going to proclaim to the congregation what just happened. In the presence of God, and before this congregation, Victoria and Richard have given their consent and made their marriage vows to each other. They have declared their marriage by the joining of hands and by the giving of rings. I therefore proclaim they are husband and wife. Say to you, the congregation, and to the world, those who God has joined together, let no one put us out there. And Richard, you may kiss.
Jesus, You know what to do next. May I present to you Mr. and Mrs. White.
She's been the rock and backbone of all our lives in some way, and she's always there when anybody needs her. It sounds like a CV, but funny, intelligent, hardworking, and just a few of many of her qualities, but the highest one is forgiveness. A lot of forgiveness, a lot of forgiveness. And today, as if she comes down the aisle, she looks so beautiful. But I see that beautifulness every day anyway. So. I look forward to spending the rest of our lives together in marital bliss as well. So that's all I've really got to say, but a quick toast to my beautiful wife, Victoria White.
Victoria and White?
We ain't got the shampoos yet, have we? Oh, Pete. And I will always love her, now and forever. Truthful. Love you. On a final note, we'll have a toast to King Richard and Queen Victoria. Yeah.
So many people here looking beautiful, smiling, having a great day. I'd like to thank you all for coming. I hope you're enjoying yourselves, so. I'd like to thank the vicar and everybody at Bedford Church for a great ceremony. I'd also like to thank my brother for asking me to be his best man. Yeah. After everyone else has said no. Yeah. So we're all here today to celebrate Vicky and Richard's marriage. As far as I can tell, everything's going far too well. Yeah. As you may or may not know, Richard and Vicky have been together going on 18 years now. It was great to see them finally tie the knot in front of everybody they love and know. Beautiful day all round. I'm not going to tell any stories about what Richard or Vicky may have had, because from what they tell me, it's all over fault anyway. I'd just like to finish, it's a short and sweet. I couldn't be prouder to see my brother marry Richard. Richard. But I wish Richard, Vicky, Ruby, Beth and Millie many, many years of happiness. So if you'd all like to raise a glass again, please. Oh, yeah. I'd like to propose a toast to Mr. and Mrs. White. Yeah.
It means more to me than you'll ever recognise. Rolling back then to about September 2002,
I boarded the 57 bus to Nuneaton to start my new college course because I failed the first one. And I sat opposite me was Vicky. We got chatting and we found out we were on the same course in college, and then I got social anxiety and got off the bus in Nuneaton instead of getting off at college. And we were in the same classroom, and that's where our friendship started. So, with many memories that I could tell you, and probably lots that Vicky wouldn't want me to tell you. Push and punch, no? Too much? Okay. So, one that I will tell you, it's quite easy going, the kids can listen to. We were watching My Girl, we'd been to Blackpool for the evening, we got ready, pre-drinks, we're about 17, 18 years old. Watching My Girl, do you remember? That was on in the background. And it was the bit where's Taryn? What's his name? Glasses! You can't see without his glasses! And we were in hysterics. Our makeup was ruined. We had to start all over again. And that was, and we were also in our black and white tops, if you remember rightly. So rolling on a little bit further to 2004. This is the start of, where's Angelica? There she is. So we all started to party at Angelica's house, more affectionately known as Angie's Den. So this is where Vicky and Dickie met, which Vicky mentioned in his speech. So for that, I'd like us all to raise a glass to Miss Angelica. Right then, so the Whites, to me, you're more than friends, you're my family. You've been there for one of mine. I rang in sick for work and said I had a terrible stomach ache so I could be there when Ruby was born. The ups, the downs, the all in betweens, and you both have been there for me and my family, and I'll be forever grateful to be in your lives. Now, there's something that Vic said at my wedding that I want to reiterate to you two. And that is that through married life, there will be many ups and downs, won't there, Ben? Yeah? There'll be many ups and downs, but when you are feeling stressed or when you're feeling it's all too much, just remember how you feel right now. Richard, are you listening? Remember how you feel right now. Okay, and just that will get you through. So, now, just before I do a taste of the bride and groom, Vicky did actually ask me to do a rap, do you remember? Now I'm not clever enough with all them TikTok folk, and I can't do a rap with words in it that I've made up by myself, but I do know one rap. So I will do that for you today. Would you guys see the best way to come and help me? DJ!
Victoria and Barbon. Named after my sister, the middle name. She is 37 years old and 51 days. Her birthstone is pearl, and as a child, she was a little bit accident prone, which you may find out about later. We are gathered here today to celebrate the wedding of Victoria and Richard, as our night wet speaker is where we long. Firstly, and I know it's a little bit late, Richard, welcome to the family. My daughter Victoria, Anne. If I'm out now, I will be able to speak. Spell V-I-C-K-I-E. She was given to me in Angela. But come on the 13th of June, 1985. It also happened to be a similar. I played, and she was at school. I played the game, and she was a mother. I played the game, now she's a beautiful boy. Where has the time flown? 37 years ago, I was welcoming you into the world. We've had our ups and downs as a family, as any family does. But I'm so proud to be standing next to my Vicky. As I may have mentioned, what a beautiful bride she is. But more important than that, what a wonderful, caring and loving person she has become. She has a tremendous and sensitive heart and a heart of gold. I will not embarrass her with any childhood stories, except maybe one.
Is it
Chateau Coupard? No. As a child, she was always accident prone. The four of us out on a bike that winded along the curse. It could only happen to Vicky. She fell off the towpath into the curse. Well, we let her out until she got her bike back. There are many stories that we share as a family, and I'll treasure, but the three children are right there at the centre and the heart. They've lit my light bulb, and we'll now say goodbye to the second one. And next year will be the third one. We will be welcoming another father into the family. But for some strange reason, we seem to be doing it in reverse order. The biggest blow in my heart on this wedding day is I am so lucky to be the first man to shoot off. And always the Lord that treasure you up. As I said, the short speech, Vicky and Richard, congratulations.
The Dennis House has everybody raising glasses to Martin, obviously, and which Vicky and Vicky.
Martin! Martin! Martin!
Then would you please welcome to the dance floor for their first dance together as a married couple, your bride, Andrew.